About 17 years ago, and not so far away, there was a feverish email campaign that ran during the UK census of 2001 that urged people to record their faith as Jedi, or Jediism. Since then, the Church of Jediism has been officially founded, and says that it has over 500,000 followers. The church has a holy book, websites, weddings, funerals, ceremonial dress, and online sermons, among other things you'd find in other churches and religions. And yes, the ceremonial robes are exactly what you think they are. They also include these. Just because I own a lightsaber doesn't mean I subscribe to the teachings of the church. These are just super cool and totally fun to own. On the other hand, there are a lot of teachings in the religion that you do have to participate in. And because this is such an interesting and modern religion, I feel like I should quickly outline what Jediism is before I can tell you how it happened. After the 2001 census, things got real, and the Church of Jediism was founded by a bro named Daniel Jones. He has a Jedi name that he uses within the church, and I'm probably going to butcher the pronunciation, but it's something like Morda Heehole. Morda Heehole, I'm just gonna call him Daniel, took the religious rank of Grandmaster and is the head of the Jedi Order, sort of like the Jedi Pope.
See? Very Pope-like. He wrote the holy book of this religion, called Become the Force, 9 Lessons on Living as a Jedi Master, that outlined the beliefs, practices, and goals of the religion, working the teachings of this holy book into his online sermons. It's pretty impressive how well he keeps his calm with constant criticism from other religions, but he, and most other practitioners of Jediism, hold true to their beliefs and continue to follow the ways of the Force.
The entire universe.
I never said, I'm just the only one, but we strive...
It's slightly overstating your position in the firmament. I mean, I'm not being funny, but I mean... To call yourself the peacekeeper of the entire universe seems a little overstating your powers.
Not really. I think we all have it's like saying the neighbourhood watch it. We've like gone to somebody's house who's part of the neighbourhood watch saying, really, you watch the entire neighbourhood? Don't be silly. No, we all have a role to play. We all do our part for it. So we're part of a community of people who are peacekeepers. We are people who promote peace and harmony. And it's the role that you take on when you're doing something, when you're part of this movement.
A real-world Jedi follows the philosophical and spiritual parts of the religion shown in the Star Wars films, with a real-life practical approach. Most of them don't hold out their hand and expect things around them to float. Most of them. Some do apparently believe in telekinesis through use of the Force. Others believe humanity's technological advancements and manipulation of communication through airwaves to be evidence of the Force. Practices and other beliefs include meditation, mindfulness, doing good deeds, helping to forward society in a positive manner, and more that I'll get into later. They also practice peacekeeping, healthy eating, staying hydrated, and other bodily health practices. The religion believes this to be missing from many people's lives, and aims to help people put this into practice in their own lives. So, overall, pretty good stuff. Peace is a core belief of the religion, and fighting is not believed to be warranted except in defense of the innocent and defense of oneself. And, much like the religion in the movies, the Jedi do not believe in a god. They believe instead in the Force, and that the Force is a life energy that surrounds all things and connects all things.
Life creates it. Makes it grow. Its energy surrounds us and binds us. Luminous beings are we, not this crude matter. You must feel the Force around you. Here, between you, me, the tree, the rock, everywhere. Yes, even between the land and the ship.
And it is believed to carry the spirit after death. So yeah, Force ghosts like these fellows over here. Who wouldn't want to come back and chill looking 30 years younger? The mission statement from Jediism include the following points. They believe
in the Force and in the inherent worth of all life within it, in the sanctity of the human person. They oppose the use of torture and cruel or unusual punishment, including the death penalty. They believe in a society governed by laws grounded in reason and compassion, not in fear or prejudice. They believe in a society that does not discriminate on the basis of sexual orientation or circumstances of birth, such as gender, ethnicity, and national origin. They believe in the ethic of reciprocity, and how moral concepts are not absolute, but vary by culture, religion, and over time. In the positive influence and spiritual growth and awareness of society. In the importance of freedom of conscience and self-determination within religious, political, and other structures. In the separation of religion and government and freedoms of speech, association, and expression. Being aware of the results of action and inaction. Being wary of material and personal attachment. Using your skills to the best of your ability, but not being prideful or boastful. Understanding your limitations and learning from your mistakes. Patience, integrity, mindfulness of one's actions and thoughts. Empathy, the belief that one should always do the right thing. Courage, and morality, and knowing the danger of belief. There's a lot more, but these are the main points.
Now that you sort of know what the Jedi actually believe, we can start looking at the factors that have caused people to identify with and follow the religion. The founder had his own ideals in mind, and many share those beliefs and thoughts, but the religion has grown, and other people have their own reasons for joining now. When he wrote the Holy Book and founded the church, assuming he wasn't in it for the money, he had a few key things in mind. Daniel Jones, like many, is obviously an enormous fan of Star Wars. That's not to say that everybody in the religion is a giant fan. Some people are in it for the core beliefs, but for Daniel, his love of the franchise is a large factor in what caused him to found the church. He had a general dissatisfaction with other religions and wanted something he believed could make people better than what was available. He liked some aspects of other faiths, but many of them had elements that he didn't believe were conducive to a peaceful and wholly inclusive environment. For example, he disliked many of the phobias that many religious peoples have of select groups of individuals because of their interpretations of the religion's teachings, and he wanted a religion where the beliefs were outlined and set in a concrete manner to avoid this. The reason being, he wanted no miscommunications and teachings that allowed for people to interpret it as a way to exclude, alienate, or have hate for other people. I.e., he wanted a religion where the people were more accepting of differences in culture and preferences. He also wanted a religion that was more focused on improvement of oneself, and many of Jediism's teachings are of self-improvement and self-care. This came about because Daniel reasoned that to better society through religion, any given religion cannot seek to change society, as many of them do. He believes that society can only be truly improved through the betterment of every individual, and that every individual must be their best self before they can effectively help others. He also desired a religion that could more easily be applied directly to daily life. The outlines in the religion are not left up to interpretation, as previously mentioned, and because the religion is more modern than many other religions, its teachings are designed and structured more toward use in daily life today. Contrast this to much older religions, where the teachings may be applicable today, but may also be somewhat dated. He also wanted to create a church where people didn't have to be die-hard believers to take part. Because sermons are done online, and most of the teaching is done by oneself, the religion is very flexible, and very accepting of people who study the teachings in a more light-hearted manner. Many people in the church are there simply because they are fans of the Star Wars franchise, and the church encourages these people to take what they can from the teachings, even if it's just a good time. Because of this, the religion is also much easier to access than some others, which was another of Daniel Jones's desires when he founded the church. In terms of economics, you could argue that the popularity in fan culture could be considered an economic reason for the creation of this religion. I would argue, though, that it would be more of an artistic reason. Art is an enormous source of inspiration for the religion, of course being based off of religion from a popular film series. Film is a form of art, hence the enormous artistic connection to the religion, as the religion would not exist without art. The religion is heavily influenced by fan art creations and creations that could be considered art, such as the ceremonial robes of religion and things like replicas of lightsabers and more. The religion was successfully created from an art form and the beliefs of the world within that art form.
The religion as a whole has always been heavily influenced by technology. You could take the lightsaber, for example. It has a sound card and an LED lighting system, which is quite technological. However, the religion would not have ever gotten off the ground as fast as it did without the use of email, which helped it spread very quickly. Besides that, it wouldn't have continued to grow without the internet and the way we use it today.
The religion doesn't have a deep-seated base in politics like some religions do. Politics aren't a major part of the religion, as it is very new and doesn't quite have the same following as other religions. That being said, from the perspective of the government, it is accepted as a religion by most countries in census and by tax agencies. The main complaints from other churches, who believe it ridiculous or blasphemous, and it's not really hated on by the average person because of its wholesome beliefs, mostly just other religious people. People in society have chosen this religion for a variety of reasons. Some desire a religion without the checkered past that other major religions have. Some want a religion with more optimistic views, or a religion they feel more accepted in. Some desire a more unifying religion that accepts other religions as all part of humanity despite differences. Some have a desire for a religion that has concrete ideals and less left to interpretation, and align with Jediism's clearly outlined values and ideals. Some people like the freedom of expression it offers, and how they can access the religion without traveling to a place of worship. Whatever the reason, the numbers of people involved in the religion are growing, and these people want to follow the teachings of the Jedi. May the Force be with you, and thank you for watching.